At this moment, the Rainbow's Daughter and the Rose Princess approached them, and Polychrome said, "What have you found, Shaggy One?"
"Either an old friend or a stranger," he replied.
"Oh, there's a sign on his back," cried Betsy, who had knelt down to examine the man. "Dear me, how funny! Listen to this." Then she read the following words engraved upon the copper plates of the man's body: "Smith and Tinkers. Patent double action, extra responsive, thought creating, perfect talking, mechanical man. Fitted with our special clockwork attachment, thinks, speaks, acts, and does everything but live."
"Isn't he wonderful?" exclaimed the princess.
"Yes, but here's more," said Betsy, reading from another engraved plate. "Directions for using. For thinking, wind the clockwork man under his left arm, marked number 1. For speaking, wind the clockwork man under his right arm, marked number 2. For walking and action, wind clockwork man in the middle of his back, marked number 3. N.B. This mechanism is guaranteed to work perfectly for 1,000 years.
"If he's guaranteed for 1,000 years, said Polychrome, "he ought to work yet."
"Of course," replied Shaggy. "Let's wind him up."
In order to do this, they were obliged to set the copper man upon his feet in an upright position, and this was no easy task. He was inclined to topple over, and had to be propped again and again. The girls assisted Shaggy, and at last Tick-Tock seemed to be balanced and stood alone upon his broad feet.